skipping, the greatest sport ever created. It's fun. It cuts your grass. It's portable. And best of all, it's relaxing. But the other day, as I was having my after-exercise shower, I slipped. And as I was lying there, I had a thought. Okay, before I attempt to see if I can skip fast enough to stop the rain, I'm going to do some very bad maths to figure out how fast I actually need to skip. So I looked up the average speed of a raindrop, which travels at around 10 meters a second and has a width of 3 millimeters, which is around 10,000 millimeters a second. And if the skipping rope is 4 millimeters thick, 800 rotations a second to stop every drop of rain from hitting your head. And after doing a quick skipping rope test myself, I'm actually pretty close with around 3 rotations a second. So either I need to step up my steroid cycle or find another way to do it. And after looking online, I found this Chinese kid who currently holds 2 world records. The first as the fastest jump roper in the world. Help! And the second for the most amount of ants killed in 30 seconds, managing to do 216 skips and kill 10,127 ants, which works out at around 7 skips a second. So I got excited and immediately sent him a message asking if he wanted to join me in the shower where I could pour water on him, but he never responded. Which means I'm going to have to cheat and make something much stronger than me and this kid. And I think I know where I want to start, with this cement mixer. And my idea is simple. I have this bent rod stuck in here with a skipping rope on one end so that when I turn it on, it acts like a spinning arm.
Not work.
And that was crap. The rope didn't do a full rotation at all. It kind of just wobbles in one spot. But after doing a little bit of research, I found this strange advertisement for a skipping rope machine made for children that are either incredibly lazy or that have no arms. And it works way better than my cement mixer, even though the motor is much slower and weaker. Probably because the spinning arm that the rope is attached to is much longer. So I made this slightly scary looking arm and attached it.
This thing is terrifying. It's pretty good. So take this face shield, put it on. Feet to the beat. Jump, jump, jump it. Set your speed and take the lead. Jump, jump, jump it. With a friend, just shake and bend. Jump. Okay, stop. Let's try faster. Just obviously, if it gets tangled, release immediately because otherwise the blades will come into my head.
Alright.
Okay, ready, set, go. Jump, jump, jump it. Set your speed and take the lead. Jump, jump. Okay, stop.
And after the rope snapped and whipped me in the eye, I decided it was time for me to make it much faster and stronger. And after raiding the bin of the local pool shop, I found these. But more importantly, this. A 2,500 watt pool pump, which spins at 2,800 rotations per minute with a 7 meter minimum head. My head is only around 40 centimeters, but hopefully it should still work. So I just got a giant metal blade, drilled a hole in it, and attached it to the motor, which seems slightly dangerous.
Just a sword attached to a motor.
So I secured the motor to the table and piled up some stuff to make sure I don't decapitate a passerby, and turned it on.
If you hear me scream, come into the garage. Actually, you should probably stand away from that. Three, two, one. Okay,
the motor starts slowly, which is actually good for me, as it will increase my chances of being able to skip. And the blade also didn't fly off, which gave me confidence to see how fast this thing will go.
3, 2, 1. That's
so terrifying.
It is fast, and I didn't let it build up to full speed, as I didn't like it that the high-pitched noise it was producing was getting higher and higher and louder and louder. But I'm happy with it, and decided I would attach some more things that can fly off and kill me. Like these bearings on the end, so that when the skipping rope is spinning around, it doesn't get tangled up. So I just clamped them down, then welded them in place. And I don't know if you've ever watched life hack videos on TikTok or Facebook, but they always weld directly to the bearing when they're building their weird life hack cock and ball torture devices. So I believed it would work. But it doesn't. These bearings do not turn. And I think it's because the little balls inside must be arcing and then welding to each other, which means I'll need to friction fit the bearings. So I cut out a small section of pipe and welded it onto the metal strip, then pressed the bearing into it. Oh, come on! Which didn't work either. So I'm going to get even more janky, and I'm going to use these washers and some super glue to very precariously hold the bearings on. And I am dying to see if this will work. So I just poked through the rope and attached the other side to an anvil. And after giving it a spin with my hand, I reckon this might work.
Please work. Kind of works.
And that was a little disappointing, but I'm hoping it was just because the rope was turkey slapping the ground. So I pulled it back so that the rope is just above the ground and gave it another go.
3, 2, 1. That is much faster.
Which worked much better, but still nowhere near fast enough. So I reckon I can fix this by reducing the weight of the spinning arm with some wood. But because of the thickness of the wood, I've also had to cut the nut which holds the spinning arm to the motor in half, which really doesn't give me much confidence.
3, 2, 1. Together, that is so much faster.
And the wood spins much faster than the steel. But for some reason, as soon as I added the rope, it slowed down heaps.
Why is it slower?
And I'm wondering why it's getting slower, because the wood is rubbing against the motor. I was like, why is this so hot as well? That makes so much sense. Okay, round 4, this time with a split in the wood.
3, 2, 1. Okay.
Wood snapped in half. So I think the wood is a bit too weak.
But I ignored my own advice and attempted to use the wood again, but this time with another washer to give the wood some support.
3, 2, 1. Whoa.
Holy shit! Fuck no!
I cannot use wood.
And after that great success, I decided I would go back to using the steel, but add another rope, so there is double the chances of it hitting the raindrops. And to do that, I need to attach the other side of the ropes to something that spins. As if it doesn't rotate, the ropes will get tangled and will then pull themselves into the giant death blade. And I reckon these bearings which came off a lazy Susan will probably rotate enough for that. But after a quick test, it's very obvious this lazy Susan doesn't want to spin.
That's crap. Susan.
But then I had an amazing, revolutionary idea. Maybe I can invent a tiny palm-sized spinning device with a bearing in the middle that has two bearings on each side. So then you can hold it in the middle and it can spin freely. So I came up with a couple of designs and this one works the best. And I reckon if anyone watching wants to make a pile of money, all you need to do is mass produce these cheap in China and then sell them to children all over the world. Just get me in on some of the profits. Okay, the palm spinner idea seems to work. The rope is making a full rotation without getting tangled. But I'm kind of worried the 3D printed plastic will break while spinning at high speed and then the wires will come loose, creating the world's largest whippersnipper. So I stacked up some more stuff to protect my family who are on the other side of this wall in case the whole thing flies apart. Then gave it a full speed test.
3, 2, 1. Did that work? Double rope? Now.
And I am amazed. I've never made something that works first go before. And the high-speed camera confirms that the palm spinner is doing a great job of rotating and not tangling the ropes. But just like Paul Walker, I need to go faster. And I've realized how. Aluminium.
Beautiful.
3, 2, 1.
That worked really well. Maybe too well, actually, as I think I almost turned it into a propeller. So I attached the metal wires, and luckily while doing that, discovered that the 3D printed palm spinner had broken. So I used the last of my skateboard bearings and created a new spinner out of aluminium and super glue. Now I'm ready for the final test before trying to jump rope fast enough to stop the rain.
3, 2, 1. Oh my God, that's quick.
And I reckon that's as fast as I'm gonna get it. So I put some Loctite on the bolt of the propeller to make sure that it wasn't coming off. And then gave it a proper tighten. And then I grabbed some stuff around the house to make one of those stupid rain devices that every single... So now, hopefully, when I open this tap, the water runs through the hose into the bath, past his legs, down the drain, through the pipe, and then out the head before it falls directly onto this wire. And I was about to turn it on for a test, but luckily remembered that my yard is always filled with birds that fly around. And the last thing I want to do is create a magpie pie. So I decided I would just wait for night.
Nice.
And before testing the machine, I thought I should have a go at skipping so we can get a comparison and see how bad I am.
Oh, it's gonna be so cold. Go. It's not doing anything.
And at first I thought I got all cold and wet for nothing, but after looking at the high speed, you can actually see that the skipping rope was doing something and hit the rain, leaving a trail of mist, which gives me hope that the full speed test will create an air bubble force field around me. And my original intention was to attempt to skip in the middle of this machine, but after seeing what happens when it goes wrong and seeing what happens when it goes right, I'm not gonna risk it. But Chinese Jump Rope Kid, if you're watching, the offer's still open if you want to come smash your own world record. Okay, I decided to start with the shower setting, which most resembles rain. And at first glance, that didn't seem very successful either. But in the slow-mo, you can see that it definitely impacts more raindrops than before and creates a line of mist where the rope spins. And it does it especially well against the larger raindrops. So I changed the setting on the hose and gave it another go. Soaker. And this is awesome to watch. I kind of feel like I'm watching a battle take place. Raindrops versus an insane man. And it doesn't hit often, but when it does, it's extremely satisfying. I was entertained for at least 3 minutes while editing, having fun betting on which raindrop is going to explode. It also worked slightly better when I used the mist setting. But not because it hit the drops, but because it creates a kind of circular airflow which slightly changes the path of the rain. But besides that, is a complete failure. It stops maybe 1 out of 100 raindrops. But while watching the slow-mo, I realized something it is not a complete failure at. The giant lights placed directly behind the giant spinning wires means I've created the world's largest, most elaborate bug killer. Poor guy. Okay, let's chuck some stuff into it.
Okay, this is what it did to the banana. Not very impressive, but the banana did this to the machine. This thing is so
And that was also a waste of a banana. But luckily, I've been learning to grow heaps of delicious bananas at home with the help of today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people, so you can explore new skills, develop existing interests, and get lost in creativity. I've been loving this course on indoor gardening by Etkart Chaudhary, who's taught me how to grow amazing plants in my own house without the need for a yard or even a patio. Before, I used to kill my plants, but thanks to Etka, who's got a PhD in ecology, I now get amazing produce every single time. Skillshare is curated specifically for learning, meaning there are no ads, and they're always coming up with new premium classes. Whether you're a dabbler or a pro, a hobbyist or a master, Skillshare has a class for every skill level. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare so you can start exploring your creativity today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like that, please subscribe and check out some of my other stuff.